Amen. Wave at it. Tell your
Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Bless him, Lord.
Glory to God.
Glory Glory to the name of God. Just keep on praising him, church. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. As the Spirit started moving, I started thinking about Paul writing to Timothy. And in 2 Timothy, he told him in verse 1:6, I'm just going to paraphrase it. I ain't reading it out. He said, but stir up those gifts that are inside you. He said, I'm convinced you have the same thing that your mama had and that your grandmother had. I've not seen it in you yet, but hallelujah. I believe it's there. Stir up what is inside of you. Hallelujah. I'm telling you, some of you guys got something in you that need to be stirred up. Hallelujah. It's been prophesied. It was prophesied by the Bible that Holy Spirit would come down. And I'm convinced that we got some people that have a gift inside them that needs to be stirred up. Hallelujah. We got to get it going again. Hallelujah. But before you can stir it up, let me tell you, you got to know about Jesus Christ. This right here is supposed to be a special service, and it has been tonight. The Holy Ghost has moved wonderfully. And Charlie said it was getting to know your church. But let me tell you, let me introduce you to Jesus Christ and who he is. Hallelujah. You know that Revelations 2:4 says, I have someone against thee because thou hast left that first love. Hallelujah. You got to love Jesus. If you want that stuff stirring up inside of you, you got to have a love for Jesus Christ to get it going in your son and I do nothing on my own. I don't sing on my own. I don't preach on my own. I don't pray on my own. I don't read on my own. I don't meditate on the word of God. I do nothing without that spirit. I do nothing without Jesus. Hallelujah. And it's that love for Jesus that keeps me going on. Hallelujah. And whenever it starts to fizzle out, there's a problem. I gotta go back to the altar and meet Jesus all over again. I'm telling you, sometimes I get there too. Sometimes I forget who the Lord was. I went a couple weeks ago and I seen that movie Risen, and something stuck out to me in that movie. Oh, there was this little leper man and he was trying to get him some food. See, leopards couldn't be in the city like Charlie was talking about, and he wanted some food. And so he was sneaking in trying to get him some. He was starving to death, and they come out beating him with brooms and kicking him around and stuff. And my heart just broke inside because I knew what that was like. Do you remember, David, what that was like to be disowned? I know you do. You told your story. Think about it. Remember where you was. Remember when you was disowned, when this world hated you, when they would have beat you up on the ground too. Remember that time. We have forgotten where we come from. We forgot what Jesus did for us. Oh, but after they beat him, that man lay there in the dirt, covered in dirt, bleeding and crying. Oh, and my heart was breaking. And Jesus walked over to him, and he just reached down and he touched him. And that man looked at him. He just started bawling and crying. He said, nobody ever touches me. Nobody ever touches me. Do you remember when nobody would touch you? I remember when this world wouldn't touch me. I remember when my family didn't want nothing to do with me. When my mama shut the door, my daddy shut the door, my grandparents, hallelujah. I didn't have no friends. I remember when I was like a leper, hallelujah. I was so covered in sin that I was covered in disease, and nobody wanted to be around me. They was afraid that I would be contagious and that they would end up like I was. Oh, but hallelujah. There was somebody who touched me that night. Oh, my. We've forgotten our first love. Think about it, church. If you think about that night that you come to the altar, remember how dark it was. Remember how Jesus loved you and them tears flowed because you finally found love. If you still have that, you should be having tears right now thinking about where you used to be. Hallelujah. And what Jesus
Jesus did for you. We forget that. And the Lord, he gave them a warning. Whenever they went into the promised land, Moses told them blessings and cursings. And he said, take heed, unless you go over there and you get full and you get riches and you get grain and stuff and you forget what God has done for you. Oh, don't forget God. Don't forget Jesus tonight. Don't forget what he's done for you. You can't stir up that gift if you ain't got the Lord in your heart stirring it up. Hallelujah. It takes something more than yourself. Hallelujah. Because by yourself, you don't want to read. I've been there where it seems like a task just to open my Bible and read. And I'll read a line or two. And I'll have to say, God, help me. I can't comprehend. I've been there. All over the love of Jesus. Hallelujah. I have to think back to what Jesus done. I have to think back to where I was in this world. I had to let all that hurt come back in my heart of what I suffered before the Lord. And then I remember with a broken and contrite spirit, you come to know the Lord. Hallelujah. And then it starts stirring up inside of me again. Hallelujah. And I start lifting my hands and I start praising God with everything in me because all of a sudden,
today, and I've been sick for a couple days, hallelujah, and I was starting to feel a little bit far from God, hallelujah, because I wasn't able to pray like I need to pray, and I wasn't able to read like I needed to read, and that just don't work for me, because if I ain't near God, I get depressed. I gotta have Jesus. I gotta get a taste, hallelujah, and I lay there today, and I started crying. I said, Lord, I can't miss church tonight. I've gotta get out to the house, hallelujah, and the fire started hallelujah. And all of a sudden, it didn't matter how much I was aching laying there. All of a sudden, I had something in me and I could go. I love the Lord and I broke down crying even more, praising God for who he was. Hallelujah. Because I know, hallelujah, I got to keep his commandments. I got to get out to the house. I got to feed people. Hallelujah. I got to get this gift stirred up inside me. Because see, I can let
I got to get a fire going so that I can help other people. Hallelujah. And I want to see that same fire in everybody standing here. You ain't going to get it sitting on your pews. Hallelujah. If you want something in it, I've always been told, you're going to get out of this service whatever you put into it. Hallelujah. And if you ain't putting your heart into it, you ain't going to get nothing out of it. But if you ain't remembering who Jesus was and loving him, you ain't going to put your heart into it no ways. Hallelujah. I think there's some people that has forgot, hallelujah, where they come from, hallelujah. All of a sudden, life's going a little bit better for you. All of a sudden, you got a little bit of extra money. You got a job, hallelujah. All of a sudden, your family's a little bit better and stuff, and you forgot where you come from, hallelujah, and who Jesus is. Oh, I don't never want to forget that, because I don't never want to end up going back there. Bible says, take heed when you think you stand, lest you fall, hallelujah. Sometimes we get so caught up in life, and we get caught up in this Christian walk, that we forget to have a relationship with the Lord, hallelujah, and keep it stirred up, and this becomes a daily routine. Oh, I don't want no routine, though, honey. That ain't nothing. I can't deal with the routine. I can't deal with the routine in my daily life. I got to mix it up anyways. I want to go to church and not know what's going to happen that night. I want to see who's going to get healed, who's going to fall out, who's going to have to be packed out drunk, hallelujah. I want to see who's going to line these altars and get saved. I can't wait for the Lord to move in things. I got to have things wound up and fired up. I've been to churches that's on a program and stuff, and they sing a few songs. The preacher sings a little or says a few words. Ain't a drop of anointing. That ain't for me, honey. I ain't got nothing for that kind of life. I need some people that's fired up for the Lord. Just like I am. Hallelujah. We got to get it moving. You can't be afraid to move. You can't be afraid of what other people think of you. Hallelujah. I don't care what they think of me anyways, honey. They talk about me when I was in this world. I'm sure going to give them something to talk about now. Praise God. Crazy now, hallelujah. But I tell you what, I might have been crazy back then, and they might think I'm crazy now, but praise God, I had a good time with this new crazy going around, buddy. You got to get it stirred up in you. The joy of the Lord is your strength, hallelujah. The joy of the Lord is your strength. That means you got to be happy with the Lord. There got to be something down in there. I've seen people that shouted the house down. They want a thing in behind it. They left the same way they come. Because they weren't shouting because they had something in them. They was just shouting because everybody else was shouting. And they was doing a little bit of an invitation to fit in. Oh, but when that joy comes in your heart, when you realize who Jesus is, when you realize how much he loves you, hallelujah, when you get that he died for you, hallelujah, that he did everything he did just for you, you start getting a little bit happy, hallelujah. That's better than getting flowers on Valentine's Day to get someone to lay the light there. I'll just tell you it is. I ain't felt that much love ever before. Out in the world, I thought I had people love me, had some people fight over me and stuff, but that wasn't love. I got someone that went and laid their life down for me, hallelujah. That's some love. I got someone that whenever I was sitting there, couldn't be trusted. I was a liar, I was a thief, I was a drug addict. You name it, I was that, hallelujah. And the world hated me and I hated me, hallelujah. But then, Jesus loved me, hallelujah. And that's why I love him, because he first loved me. And that's why I get excited, hallelujah. Because he took this little hopeless girl that everybody thought was going to end up dead somewhere. Mama was waiting on the call any night, your daughter's dead, hallelujah. One night she did call me and said, she was all crying and stuff. She said, they called me and told me you was laying dead in a ditch. I said, not yet, Mama, hold on, not yet. I didn't deny. I was like, I'll probably get there. That's what I told him. Told him I ain't going to stop till I'm dead in jail. Had no plans on it. Hallelujah. Oh, but then I got a little bit of joy in me. I found Jesus. Hallelujah. And now I ain't going to be dead in a ditch somewhere. You're going to find me in the house of God shouting my heels down. Hallelujah. And you're going to see me trying to get other people stirred up just like me. Because once you get this stirred up in you, it's addictive and you can't stop. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. I feel
like a little kid when I'm up here. This is the only time my body don't hate. Praise God. But, you know, I see the Lord, he's trying to work. But he's trying to tell you, you got to get back to me. Go back to the cross. Get back to the cross. Amen. Cross, cross, cross. Go back to the first beginning. Remember who I am. Remember what I did for you. You remember, don't you, brother? You remember. Y'all remember where you come from, honey. If you don't, you go home tonight, you sit and think about it. And you think about it until it absolutely breaks your heart and tears come rolling. Remember who you was. Hallelujah. Because there's a pretty good chance you didn't like yourself either. I don't think I'm the only bad person in here. We won't let y'all tell it though. We'll let you keep your halos on. I'll be the only bad one. But get back to the cross. That way he can give you more. Hallelujah. Because when you feel that love for Jesus, it bubbles up inside of you and you just can't stop it from coming out. It has to come out. It's like a volcano about ready to erupt. There's so much pressure. If you don't just let it out and tell people, Jesus is the way. Jesus is the man that saved my life. Hallelujah. And before you know it, you get a little happy and you start singing songs and they're like, what's wrong with that woman? Hallelujah. And there's the joy of the God. And then you get to tapping that foot, hallelujah, with that song. You'll get to tapping away and they'll be a looking at you, thinking that old crazy thing, hallelujah. But then that little foot tapping stuff, you sit there and you start having to raise your hand with it, saying, thank you, Lord, praise God. And before you know it, honey, you're shouting, you're dancing all over the place, praise God. And then you're laying drunk in the floor, hallelujah. And then you've done been refreshed and ready for the next battle, praise God. And then you get a little bit bolder and able to stand up for God because you've done physically touched God in a way that you hadn't got to before. And then it comes a little bit easier to withstand the next test and to stand up and say, God is definitely the way. Jesus is the way. There's no other way. Hallelujah. I had a dream not long ago and it scared me to death in this dream. See, I dreamed all kinds of things going on. I seen horses coming out of a mountain. And there was a show horn, or a chauffeur that went off. The horns like they blow in Israel. It was blowing. And those horses come out. And then I thought it was over. They was beautiful wild horses, curly hair. I mean, they were just gorgeous. Then here comes some baby horses out of that mountain a-running. And I looked at someone. I'm like, that's the most beautiful thing I've ever seen in my life. And they said, they go where God tells them to. They listen for God's call. And whenever God calls them, they will go. And whenever God ain't blowing the horn, they'll stop. They know not to go into battle. Hallelujah. That's the Christians. When God's blowing his horn, we go. Hallelujah. We go after that spirit. Hallelujah. And whenever he stops, we stop. But then it transferred from me and that to I was underground in this place. And there were people all around. And they were shoving. They were fighting against somebody. They were fighting against Muslims. And then there was another country in and attacking us. And I was in the back and I was thinking to myself, my Lord, they done got a bomb. They're going to blow us up and I'm going to die in here. And I was thinking, maybe I can dig my way out of it. Hallelujah. But I knew I couldn't. So I started praying. And then I ended up above ground. And it was even worse above ground than what it was underground because above ground, Muslims run everything. And I watched them as they packed these knives around. And they were slitting Christians open left and right. And couldn't nobody stop them. They were just gutting them, leaving them for dead. And they thought it was fun and game and show. And I was stuck with this whole family of Muslims. And they didn't know that I was a Christian. And I was working with them and stuff. And all that was going through my head was, if they find out I'm a Christian, I'm a dead. And for a moment in my dream, I thought of denouncing Christ. Hallelujah. And let me tell you, when I woke up, that scared me to death that the thought even passed through my mind in my dream, because if it passed through there in my dream, it will pass out through my mind if something really goes on. You got to have love for Jesus to stand it. And I was sitting there thinking, I can't do this. And then I was like, I can't denounce Christ. I can't denounce Christ. So we went back and they were going to this family of Christians that they were using, that they were plotting to murder. And I woke up. Let me tell you, it's coming down to that. It's coming down to it. Hallelujah. It's a vital time when you better love Jesus. You better have something strong in your heart that you're willing to stand up for. Hallelujah. Where you might be there denouncing Christ. I mean, it all seems happy and
I don't know, happy and glory and this and that when we're up here shouting and dancing, and it's great and it's wonderful and it'll keep you and it'll renew your spirit. But let me tell you, for you to give that, there has to be a love down inside of you. And without that love, you ain't going to stand. This ain't a game. It ain't a joke. Hallelujah. You need that. You need the Holy Ghost. You need the full baptism of the Holy Ghost, not just the Holy Ghost down in you. You need the full baptism. Hallelujah. But you got to have Jesus. You got to remember your first love. And if you ain't remember him, if you don't know why you're raising your hand, if your praises are empty, they ain't going up anyway, something's wrong. And there's nothing wrong with getting a little bit of code sometimes. We don't want to be there. You got to recognize that you're getting code is the thing, though. Because we all go through things. We all go through dry spells and stuff. We all have times that we lift up our hands and we can't feel the Lord. Hallelujah. It's nothing new to anybody. It's something everybody goes through. Oh, but when you feel it, hallelujah, you know you got a problem. You need a breakthrough. Hallelujah. You need a broken and contrite spirit. You need to remember what Jesus did for you and get that love back in you, so that glory will come down, so that'll start stirring up in you again. Hallelujah. So that you'll be on fire. Hallelujah. When was the last time you was excited to come out to the house of God and not just come because it's something you do? I mean, when was you really, really excited thinking as soon as you woke up that day, yes, it's church day, Lord, I can't wait to get into your house tonight. I can't wait to see what's going to happen. Oh, hallelujah. I don't want to know how many people have not felt that in a while. I'd be afraid to ask. Hallelujah. Because you can tell by the services and stuff whose heart's in it and whose ain't. Hallelujah. You can tell by the move of the church. Oh, but God's wanting to do something tonight. He's wanting that excitement and that joy back in you that you felt when you first got saved. Hallelujah. When you started desiring everything that he had for you and you was willing to work no matter what it took to get every single thing he had. Whenever you was so excited, hallelujah, that you just had to go out and tell the world, Jesus saved me, hallelujah. We got to get that fire back, church. We got to get back to Jesus, our first love. Without him, we're never going to make it, hallelujah.
Come on.
Everyone just stand up. Stand up if you're able. I want y'all to sit and think. Amen. Think about where you was that night you come to the altar. Think about how dark that was in your life. Remember that time. Hallelujah. Sit and really just remember the time. Hallelujah. Just close your eyes and think about it. Don't worry about me. Close your eyes and think about where you was that night. Remember how those chains was on you. Remember everything that was going on in your life. Remember that it seemed hopeless, that there was no other way out. You had to find something. Remember that night. Remember the darkness. Remember those nights that you cried all alone that nobody knew about. And you was just hoping for something and you didn't know what was going to bring you out of it. You had no idea how to get out of that pit that you was in. But you knew it was just getting deeper and deeper and that it was going nowhere. Remember. Remember when Jesus started pulling at you and that Holy Spirit was tugging at your heart. Hallelujah. Remember the joy that you found that night. Hallelujah. Remember how good the Lord has been to you. Remember him. Remember that love that he first instilled in you. Remember when you came, how much you loved him. Remember crying out, Lord, I'll do anything for you. I'll serve you, Lord, to the end. Remember that first love of Jesus. Hallelujah. Get it in your head. Keep it in your head tonight. Meditate on it on your bed. And remember your love for Jesus. And get it stirred up. Hallelujah. Until you're able to break out crying and worshiping Jesus for who and what he is and what he has done for you.
Amen.